good to us, and those of us who have chosen the path of righteousness, the path of the Bible, we have always been on the same line with God, who is good, who is great, and who is wonderful. So you are blessed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
How great is our God, how great is his name, how great is his love, forever the same. He rolls back the waters out of mighty Red Sea, and he said, I'll never leave you, put your trust in me. Praise be the name of our God. Let us pray. We give you praise, dear God, the Messiah of all season. Thank you for bringing us together to study your word. The Bible says you have honored your word even above your name. And therefore, Father, coming to listen to the word is bringing our attention to honor you. Therefore, Father, I pray that you give us anointed understanding today. What we are learning, let it turn our life around for good in Jesus' name. Thank you for having answered. Make the Bible an open book for us, and do not allow us to fall into the deception of the end time, that we may be useful in the things that gives joy to God. Thank you for having answered. In Jesus' acceptable name, we have prayed. Amen and amen.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, I want to welcome you for the study tonight in the name of Jesus Christ. Each week, for those who have the mind to learn from God's word or to add knowledge to knowledge and wisdom to wisdom, they will have known that our frequency every Friday is not entertaining, but rather we inform based upon revealed word from the Bible. And that's exactly why we are here again today. And what we are studying is in the third of a series on Bible light about covenant. Bible light on covenant. Do not forget, the Bible has said in Psalm of David, in Psalm 119 from verse 105, it says, thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. And this is why we have chosen this title, that the Bible light on covenant. Bible word is a lamp. If you have a feet and there is no light lamp for your feet, that person continue to hit the rock every day. And if your path is not lightened, no matter how much you are ready to do things right, you just discover that that person continue to stumble across the dashboard of life. Therefore, we must put the word of God into a very strategic point in our focusing. May the Lord bless our effort in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Now, in our two previous studies on Bible light on covenant, we've been able to, number one, define what the word covenant is all about. We have also seen the dimension of covenant, that it can be between man and God. It can be between man and man. It can be between nation and nation. It can be between mankind and Satan. And we have seen different kind of covenant as identified in the Bible. And that every covenant, like as we have studied in the previous month, a week, we discovered that every covenant has a token, a sign, or a symbol. And this is what made covenant to be covenant. For instance, marriage as a covenant has a token. The token of it may be a certificate you have signed. It may be what you have given to the family that you are marrying from. It's a form of token. And some other type of tokens are given. And that covenant, also we have learned that covenant is powerful. Just like prayer is powerful and fasting is also powerful, covenant is also as powerful. That if anyone breaks the covenant, that person is called covenant breaker. And that prayer and fasting may become helpless if the covenant has been broken. If the term of the covenant is broken, then your fasting and prayer may go extra mile and the answers may not be there at all. And that's why in part of the covenant we have studied, if you still remember, we have studied the one that we call Edenic covenant, which was the covenant that the Lord made with Adam in the Garden of Eden. And we also have studied Cainic covenant, and we treated that one in our previous studies. But in our studies today, just like the New Jerusalem, New Jerusalem. Now come in and let's see what was there in the foundation of the New Jerusalem in Revelation chapter 21. Revelation chapter 21, reading from verse 14. It says, and the wall of the city had 12 foundations, and in them the names of the 12 apostles of the Lamb. Now, what that one is trying to tell us from here is that our life is like a city with foundations. And the foundation that holds our life together, number one, may be prayer, may be fasting and repentance. Along the line, there is also covenant as another part of the lively stone that carries the foundation that will be meaningful. So do not say, how many foundations do we have? New Jerusalem had 12 foundations, and in each of these foundations, names of the apostles were written. So by every life have one type of foundation or another. And so we must need to understand very well that covenant is also one of the foundation that holds life together. It can stabilize or destabilize life. When a good foundation is made, the life of that person is stable. When a bad foundation is laid, the life of that person becomes unstable, and the foundation itself can be personal, and also it can be a family foundation. Either family or personal foundation is foundation. Now, can we see family foundation and how it can spill over to the children born into that covenant in the later years? In Psalm 89, Psalm 89, then the readings will be from verse 34. Psalm 89 from verse 34. It says, my covenant will I not break, nor alter the things that is gone out of my mouth. Once have I spoken, sworn by my holiness, I will not lie unto David. Meaning there was a covenant between God and David. And it says in verse 36, his seed shall endure forever, and his throne as the sun before me. Now, understand what God is saying from there. Even though God had a covenant with David, effect of that covenant also spill over onto the children. Now, look at what will happen if the children of David refuses to maintain the term of that covenant. Now, look at verse 30 of the same chapter. If his children, the children of David, forsake my law, my covenant, and walk not in my judgment, if they break my statutes and keep not my commandment, then will I visit their transgression with the rod, and their iniquities with stripes. Now you see that if the children of Abraham decide not to carry out the details of the agreement that is existing between David and God, he says, rod of punishment will come upon them. Now, if human being is tormenting you, you can run to God and God will save you. If Satan is punishing your family, you can go to God and God will deliver you. But when it is God who is the rod of the punishment within the family, I don't know which prophet that can be able to set such person free. Now, and that is why it's very important, whatever covenant you have with God, don't hide it away from your children, and tell them the necessity of keeping the covenant of Jehovah. Even when you are no longer alive, covenant can still continue if it is a family covenant or a generational covenant. And it says in there, in verse 33, nevertheless, after I have punished the people who refuses to fulfill my commandment, he said, nevertheless, by loving kindness, will I not utterly take away from him, nor suffer my faithfulness to fail. What is this one telling us in effect? He's telling us that foundation of life may be in covenant. Of course, it's in covenant, because when you are married, two people are in the covenant and you are born into that covenant. And so if you are born into that covenant, you are to fulfill the terms of the covenant. So it is very, very important. And it is like fulfilling what Apostle Paul said into the life of the Corinthian Christians in 1 Corinthians chapter 3. 1 Corinthians chapter 3. We want to understand what the Bible is saying, so that we don't take our mind away from the covenant of God. It says in 1 Corinthians chapter 3 from verse 10. It says, according to the grace of God which is given unto me as a wise master builder, as a covenant maker, it says, I have laid the foundation. I have laid the foundation. Just like what we are studying from the book of Genesis, when we are studying about the covenant in Eden, and covenant that God made with Cain, is a foundation that have been laid many centuries before. He says, I've laid the foundation, and another builded thereon. But let every man take heed how he builded thereupon. If you are building something contrary to what was laid in the foundation, it's going to be a crisis. He says, for other foundation can no man lay than that is laid, which is Jesus Christ. Now, if any man build upon this foundation, gold, silver, precious stone, wood, lay, hay, stubble, every man's work shall be made manifest. For the day shall declare it, because it shall be revealed by fire, and the fire shall try every man's work of what sort it is. He says, if any man's work abide, which he has built thereupon, he shall receive a reward. But if any man's work shall be burnt, he shall suffer loss. But he himself shall be saved, yet so as by fire. What are we saying here? He's trying to tell us that men, our life, somebody has laid the foundation. Your dad and your mom have laid the foundation for your existence. Now, the basis of that foundation have been laid. We create an open door, either a dark line or a life light, that will be able to make your journey to be stable in your tomorrow's life, or is going to be punishing your every step that you take. And that's why if you still have them around, ask some questions from them. What step have they taken wrongly in their matrimonial journeys? What step have they taken rightly? So that you can be able to know, because if you just believe that you are born and you are born, the past has nothing to do with your present, that person is only deceiving himself, because there is no New Testament without an Old Testament. Every life has both an Old Testament and a New Testament. Old covenant and a new covenant. A lot of people in the present generation do not want to believe that, but everything in nature has already declared that. And so, you are building on another man's foundation. You are building on another man's foundation, like Romans chapter 15 verse 20. If you are building another man's foundation, that foundation will cry. And that's why you discover some people today, no matter how much they put the effort into life, they are always harvesting disgrace. No matter how much they tried in life, some people will always fall down. Giant star will always fall under his gravity. And some people, a little effort, you discover that they are just like a morning star, like a northern star, afternoon star, shining in their brilliancy. And people will be looking at them and say, but I make more effort than this person, but you may not know the covenant that is propelling that person into that. Some people early in life, they make it, they become shining star. But when it comes to evening, everything is somersaulting back to the valley. Why some people will struggle and struggle and struggle until the evening of their life before they start to shine? All are traceable to the matter of the foundation. You are building on an umbrella man foundation. Therefore, be careful. Don't forget. In the foundation of the covenant is where everybody is running. Foundation that was laid upon Nigeria is what we are building on till today. Foundation that is laid upon your family is what you are building upon today. Now, the same way, if you are employed to a particular place of work, now the foundation of that place of work will tell upon the staff that are working in that place. The church you affiliate yourself with, now the foundation that the founder of that church has laid, if it was laid upon occultism, people will be dying instrumentally. Some people will just be struggling and struggling, they will never break through. Other people, the moment they break through, they break away. All these things are traceable to the foundation at work. Now, can we come to the Bible and understand what the Bible have to say? Because every one of us, we are building on another man's foundation in one way or another. The business you start, now you are starting it upon a particular foundation. If it's a faulty foundation, there will be faulty achievement. If it's a strong foundation, there will be strong achievement. And in the name of the Lord, the greatness of our God will remove you from embarrassing covenant in the name of Jesus Christ. Am I hearing an amen to that? Amen. Now, can we see another man's foundation upon which life is still run till today? In Genesis chapter 8, every one of us, either landlord or tenant, either director or the staff, you are the managing director of the group, managing director of whatever corporation or company you are working with, listen and understand. There's a form of covenant. You may refuse to recognize it. Somebody may have preached to you that it doesn't matter, but reality of life and reality of the scriptures have already said you are building on another man's foundation. In Genesis chapter 8, we want to see a covenant that is called Noahic covenant. That was the covenant that God made with Noah. And the beast of the field after the flood and ushered in the dispensation of human government. Now you find that in chapter 8 from verse 20. It says, "And Noah builded an ark unto the Lord and took of every clean beast and of every clean fowl and offer burnt offering on the altar. And the Lord smelled a sweet savor. And the Lord said in his heart, I will not again curse the ground anymore for man's sake." Humanity, even though it was starting from Noah, for the imagination of man's heart is evil from his youth. "Neither will I again smite anymore every living thing as I have done." He said, "Why the earth remaineth." He didn't mention a particular geographical environment, saying why America remain, or why Asia remain, or why Nigeria remain, but he says, "Why the earth remaineth, seed time and harvest, and cold and heat, and summer and winter, day and night shall not cease." Now, where we are now in Nigeria, we are in the evening time. Some other people will be there in the morning time. Other people will be in the midnight. But the truth of the matter is that it will continue to work as regular as day and night. Now, look at chapter 9 of the same Genesis from verse 12. It says, "And God said," in Genesis chapter 9 verse 12, "This is the token of the covenant which I have made between me and you and every living creature that is with you for perpetual generations." Can you see that? Covenant can span generations. You are not there when Noah was having a covenant with God, but the effect of it is what you are living under. You are building on another man's foundation. He says, "I do set my bow in the cloud, and it shall be for a token of covenant between me and the earth." So as long as you are still on earth, that covenant is still efficacious. "And it shall come to pass when I bring a cloud over the earth, and the bow shall be seen in the cloud, I will remember my covenant, which is between me and you, and every living creature of all flesh, and the waters shall no more become flood to destroy all flesh. And the bow shall be in the cloud, and I will look upon it, that I may remember the everlasting covenant between God and every living creature of all the flesh that is upon the earth. And God said unto Noah, this is the token of the covenant which I have established between me and all flesh that is upon the earth. Now understand the point from here, that it is this covenant that God made with Noah. The terms of the covenant were that, number one, that God will not curse the ground or the living creature anymore. But they have been cursed before. Number two, that man shall rule and replenish the earth forever, of which you and I, we are part of it. We do our own portion and we leave the stage. And apart from that, that animals should be eaten and not the blood thereof. It is with covenant that have been laid before you are born, and that's why you are building on another man's foundation, another man's covenant that the Lord has made in Genesis chapter 9, from verse we see that in from verse 2 and verse 3, and the fear of you and all the dread of you shall be upon every beast of the earth, and upon every fowl of the air, and upon all that moveth upon the earth, and upon all the fishes of the sea. Into your hand are they delivered, they are delivered into your hand, and every moving thing that liveth shall be meat for you. Every moving thing that liveth shall be meat for you, and every green herb have I given you all things. Now, this one is trying to tell us in verse 4 also, after the fact that we can eat all the meat and all the green herbs, there is a but in verse 4. But the flesh with the life thereof, which is the blood thereof, shall ye not eat. And surely your blood of your lives will I require at the hand of every beast, will I require it. And at the hand of man, and at the hand of every man's brother, will I require the life of man. Whoso sheddeth man's blood, by man's shall his blood be shed, for in the image of God made he man. Now understand the point there, that there should be capital punishment for murderers, and that animals should be eaten and not the blood of the animal or the blood of human being. So whoever break that rule is breaking the rule of God. Rainbow will be the sign of the covenant, and the covenant will be an eternal covenant. Now understand this. You are building on another man's foundation in a form, because you are not alive when Noah was alive. But that covenant has to do with all the living, all the earth. And that's one point you must also bear in your mind. Now that comes again to the covenant that God had with another human being, and by extension, it's also having an impact upon the present day generation, as it was in the generation of Abraham. And that is what is called Abrahamic covenant. Abrahamic what? Covenant. In Genesis chapter 12, and I'm reading from verse 1, it says, now the Lord has said unto Abraham, get thee out of thy country and from thy kindred and from thy father's house into a land I will show thee. It is like somebody collecting a migrant visa, and you are staying in another country or in another town. There is nothing wrong about it if it is the Lord that is leading you there. But some people are born to migrate. Some people are born to run. You are doing it because other people are doing it. People are moving outside the country and you also want to copy. There is a parable in Yoruba language. One hour means that if your friend fat and you yourself you want to compete with your friend that he has fatted, so what you are going to discover is that you are going to poo-poo upon your body. What that one is saying in effect is that if God is not the one inspiring you to go and change your location, if you do so, that person will come back to zero level. And it says from here, God instructed Abraham to go outside into a place he will show him, and he will make of him a great nation and bless him and make his name great and will be a blessing. Meaning that Abraham will be the first Ngozi. It's not possible for you to bless other people when you are not blessed. It is a blessed person that can bless other people. And he says he's going to make him a blessing so he can bless other people. May God bless my audience. Wherever you are, may the Lord bless you to a point you can be a blessing to other people. Say amen to that. He said, I will bless them that bless thee, and curse him that curseth thee. And in thee shall all the families of the earth be what? Blessed. Now from the point I've read here, now after the confusion of tongues, when he doesn't want to deal with the whole race, it ushers in what I call the dispensation of promise. And in the dispensation of promise is the covenant of circumcision. Covenant of what? Circumcision. He was made with Abraham, and by extension, everyone that is born to fulfill God's covenant, they fulfill it for every male child. In Genesis chapter 17, reading from verse, we see there in from verse 1, the story was been there, and was talking about the covenant here and covenant there and all. But at the end of the day, he now talk in verse 10, chapter 17, verse 10. This is my covenant with which you shall keep between me and you and your seed after thee. Every man child, not a woman child, but a man child among you shall be circumcised. So the covenant that God enacted with Abraham was that every male child should go through covenant of circumcision. Now, medically, it is done. It is blessing. But to go and do circumcision for female, it is not part of the covenant that God wanted. And whoever is going after that is breaking the covenant of God, and that person is identified as a covenant breaker. So you are building on another man's foundation. Take heed of how you are building that foundation. He says, every man child among you shall be circumcised, and ye shall circumcise the flesh of your foreskin, and it shall be a token of covenant between me and you. And he that is eight days old shall be circumcised among you. Every man child in your generations, he that is born in the house or bought with money of any stranger which is not of your seed. Can you see that? Now you are building on another man's foundation, so you will be careful. God has already called Abraham as his choice friend. And he said, my covenant with you is that there must be a circumcision upon your male child. And for whatever reason, anything that has to do with you, if they obey that instruction, my blessings will be upon them. I hope you are taking care of how you are building upon the foundation that another has set. There's nothing you can do about that foundation. That covenant is already there. Your own is only to comply. Otherwise, that person will become a covenant breaker. How many covenant breakers do we have in our churches today? In our nations today? In our continents today? Some people, because of a little change they have in their hands, they look around themselves, they say, well, the covenant of man marrying man is obsolete. Man marrying woman is obsolete. Can we introduce a new dimension of man marrying man? You are breaking the covenant. Can we introduce the covenant of woman marrying woman? You are breaking the covenant. Can we introduce the covenant of marrying animal? Breaking the covenant. So many ungodly ways by which people are becoming covenant breakers today, they are there. So you must be very careful. There is a Bible light on covenant, and it must be followed by those who want Abrahamic blessing. The song we normally sing is, Abraham blessings am I. If Abraham blessings are yours, you must be willing to follow the covenant that has been given to Abraham. And of course, you know Abraham will pay his tithe. Even though the modern teachings is trying to lure people away from tithe payment, Abraham will be committed to God regardless of whatever is on ground. Some people now, they are only committed to themselves. They fence themselves away from any reach of anybody. They are just captain on their head and head of state in their hearts. And they are not willing to be led by the Lord of heaven anymore. But for children of God, you must need to keep Abrahamic covenant. Apart from that, there's another one that is called Agaric covenant. Covenant that God made with Agar. Now, that was through Ishmael, Abraham's son. It concerned many generations And what information you also need to learn about it is in chapter 16, Genesis chapter 16. Let's see. Now, don't forget, who was Hagar? Hagar was the one who gave birth to Ishmael. You know that Abraham had some delay in childbirth, and Abraham was on his own until no human being to wait for God's timing on anything. We're restless. Waiting is not in a dictionary, but God will always want a God-praying servant to be a God-waiting servant. But when they waited and they felt they should help themselves, that was where they gave birth to generations that are not meant to exist. And but God still need to fence them. But let's see what was the bond that existed between the seed of Abraham, chapter 16, from verse 10 to verse 12. Now we want to see, Hagar was Sarai's house help. And along the line, you read the whole story from verse 1. He says, and the angel of the Lord, that was after that girl has given birth to the child, said unto her, I will multiply thy seed exceedingly, that it shall not be numbered for multitude. And the angel of the Lord said unto her, behold, thou art with a child, you are pregnant, and shall bear a son, and shall call his name Ishmael, because the Lord has heard thy affliction, and he will be a wild man, very aggressive, wild man, and his hand will be against everybody, and every man's hand will be against him, meaning that he will be using small hand to collect big bullets. He will have a little bunch of whatever, but when it is the time again, people will rise up, they will combine themselves, their forces together to beat that child. He will have a strong head, that the child you are giving birth to, he will be a strong head child, that when he's only will only be to go and fight somebody. He says, every man's hand shall be against him, and he shall dwell in the presence of all his brethren, meaning that all his brethren, they will see him clearly where he's going to be. And he called the name of the Lord that spake to her, that God seest me, for he said, have I also here looked after him that seeth me? Now understand this. Now Ishmael that was born, God says the covenant that will be between Ishmael and God, will, number one, is going to be a wild person. They will not be a humble person or gentle person or see from the perspective of anybody, ready to fight at no issue at all. That is the constitution of a child that was not meant to exist, but God has to accommodate him because he's from Abraham. And he says his hand will be against everybody. And the generation of Ishmael today, they only are happy when there is war, and they can come up with all manner of cliques to wipe out a generation, to destroy a people, to become to carry bomb in their body and burn themselves and burn other people and burn other nations, reduce people into rubbles and all, because of the negative impact of their arrival. Say, every man's hand shall be against him. And when you look into the history of the world today, you don't need no prophet to tell you whether that is fulfilled or not. The Bible is an open book, a book of covenant. Therefore, all that one is saying to you and I is that God has a covenant with the son of Abraham. The covenant to be confined, it will continue to move on until it becomes a great nation. Today, there are nations that came up from Ishmael. Until today, they are still very, very active. Now, there's another one that is called Sarai covenant. Covenant that God has made with Sarah. And that one is there in Genesis chapter 17. Now, you read all the story. Even though there was a delay before Sarah eventually conceived, an angel came in and said, your wife in the 9 months or 12 calendar months is going to carry the baby and all. It was like, will it ever happen? Even when things were working, things are not working. But now you say it's going to happen. Let's see how it happened. And that's why after the fullness of the time eventually showed up, now he gave birth to a child that is called God Make Me Laugh. Because who will hear that an old person gave birth to a child unassisted, Now, that can only be God, and miracles still happen till today. And when that child was born, the name was called Isaac. Isaac in Yoruba language means familiarity. Make me laugh. Anybody who hears will laugh. So if you read from verse 1, you will discover it was very, very clear. Now, after that child was born, guess what happened? A miracle was there. And the next thing that happened was that the child, Isaac, the covenant was to be conferred unto him forever. Covenant of God. So in summary, today I believe the Lord has spoken to you in one way or the other about the issue of foundation. There are foundations that you cannot do anything about. You must need to continue. That foundation, is another word for it is covenant. Now, you need to work upon it. Now, there are some people, we are still coming to the covenant between man and Satan. Don't forget, we are looking at biblical covenant in order of appearance. Now, what we are saying here, in essence, is that, is there any foundation you are breaking? The rule of that foundation you are breaking, and you want to substitute it for fasting and prayer? You want to substitute it for giving to God? Now, giving to God is good. It's a form of foundation for time to come. But it is different from you taking care of the foundation that is laid before ahead of you. There are some foundations that are laid in blood. The father who formed the family went into a terrible occultism. When we come to that, we'll see into the Bible, and we'll see the reason why some people, their lives are upside down. But I pray for everyone who is hearing me today that your testimony will come out good in the name of Jesus Christ. My question to you today as we round up is, who laid the foundation of your current challenges? Who laid the foundation of the story that you are running presently? How was it laid? What was the term of the covenant? A lot of people are looking away. Please don't look away. If Christ is not your Lord and Savior, you have so many things to contend with. And that's why happy are those people who have accepted Jesus as Lord and Savior, because they have an advocate. The one who has shed his blood, whose blood is still efficacious till today, to save people and help them away from harassment and embarrassment. My brother, congratulations if you have accepted Jesus as Lord and Savior. But more than you accepting, you must need to invoke the blood of Jesus as a token of covenant against the bad covenant that may have been laid concerning your life, concerning your choice. Some people, it is the only thing they have not known over time, and that's why their 3 days journey is becoming 30 years. So today the Lord is saying, get things right, and if you do not know who laid the foundation of your family, your current challenges, and your current story you are running, and is giving you a hard time, come back to Christ. He is the only covenant blood that can confront another covenant of evil. You must need to lay a good foundation today. According to 1 Timothy chapter 6 from verse 9, lay a good foundation. Jesus is the good foundation that if you have it, around your story becomes sweeter. In 1 Timothy chapter 6 from verse 9, he says, in 1 Timothy chapter 6 from verse 19, it says, laying up in store for themselves a good foundation against the time to come, that they may lay hold on eternal life. Who is the good foundation? It is Jesus Christ. Confess your sins to God, the sins of your ancestors, to God that have been crying unto God. He said, Cain, where is your brother Abel? He said, because the voice of your brother's blood is crying to me from the ground. Grandfathers of some people have already killed some people, and their blood from generation to generation is still crying. Why don't you come to Christ and lay a good foundation against the time to come? And I opened the last verse of the Bible that will be very useful for you to know the way out of all of this harassment that is coming upon the world, because nobody seems to have clearer understanding again, and everybody is running to what I call class mass society. But the Lord is saying, there is a time when you can be ignorant, and there is a time when you can break away from your ignorance. In Colossians chapter 1, and I'm reading from verse 18. Colossians chapter 1, from verse 18 through to verse 21. And then we pray. It says, and he is the head. Who is the head? Jesus Christ. Head of the body, the church, who is the beginning and the firstborn from the dead, that in all things he might have preeminence. Preeminence means leadership. He may have control. He may have dominion. He says, for it pleased the Father that in him should all fullness dwell. And having made peace through the blood of his cross, it's only Jesus that died for you. And that's the only thing that can answer. And by him to reconcile all things, including your scattered family, including the premature death, including not making it in life, including you not having a shining testimony, reconcile all things into himself. And by him, I say, whether they be things in earth or things in heaven, and you that were sometimes alienated and enemies in your mind by wicked works, yet now as he reconciled. If you have accepted the Lord as the Lord and Savior in your life, he has reconciled you. And you must plead that blood of Jesus. It is like you showing the receipt of the money that you have paid, or they have paid on your behalf. All that Satan wants to see for him to stop punishing you is the evidence of payment. You want to say the blood of Jesus is your evidence. What Satan is after is blood. And so today the Lord is saying to you, covenant is binding. The same way prayer is important, giving is important, fasting is important, covenant is also important. So pay the price. Show the receipt of payment. And then problems of your children, problem of your family, problem of the nation will also be rolled away. And that's why we plead the blood of Jesus. And Jesus' blood is very active till today. Congratulations for being patient to study with me in the study today. And by the grace of the Almighty God, we'll continue next week if the Lord tarries. And so the point of prayer you are going to pray between now and next week is, number one, that the Lord Almighty, he will accept you, whatever sin that your generation has committed and is crying against you presently, that the Lord will forgive. And whatever sin you yourself you have committed, when you are ignorant of what life demands, and maybe you have killed, you have aborted, you have stolen something, you have destroyed somebody's personality to be your own personality, and you are now shining star, and the one who's supposed to be enjoying that labor of his work is now suffering, you are going to say to God that the Lord will forgive you. Reconciliation is key. If you must need to restitute, restitute means pay back. When you do that, God answers your prayer. So you are going to pray, open my eyes, O God, and give me grace to do the right thing, coming to the Lord, and then to remain eternal in the hand of Jesus Christ. Congratulations for the spirit of obedience. Let us pray. Almighty Father, we thank you for your word today. Bible Light on Covenant, I believe your word has reached out unto people. People of all culture, people of all nations, people of all religious background. The word of God is key, is core, is compulsory. It's a covenant, and whoever respects it, heaven respect them. I pray that you respect the view and the actions of your people as they choose to respect you by changing their way to accept Jesus as a full reconciliator and to make reconciliation for their sins in Jesus' name. Those who are suffering terribly under the yoke of evil covenant, I pray you release them today. Amen. Thank you for having answered. Glory be to the name of the Lord. Amen. May you free your people away from their oppression. Amen. Thank you for having answered. Whatever negative covenant that is speaking around your life, I pray in the name of Jesus that the blood of Jesus will wipe them out. Amen. And ability to come out clean, the Lord will give to all my audience. Amen. Thank you, faithful Father, for having answered. When we meet next time, we'll come back with a living testimony. Amen. Thank you, we know you have answered. In Jesus' decent name, we have prayed. Amen and amen. Amen. Thank you for being part with us. You are blessed, you are loved, in Jesus' name. Amen, amen and amen. Amen. So for your offering, if you want to drop into the church account, it has been displayed, and I believe that you will do whatever God has sent you to do. Giving is part of your foundation. It will speak for time to come. May God bless you in Jesus' name. Amen. Shall we share the grace in fellowship The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life. We shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Shalom. Amen.